Haji Alizadeh is desperate to help his relatives escape from Afghanistan.
I'm very worried. I know every day I'm in contact with him and then try to basically support him. You know, I know I can't do much about it, but still support him, you know, mentally.
Tasmania's Refugee Legal Service has been fielding up to 40 calls a day from Afghan Tasmanians trying to secure Australian visas.
They're very, very desperate in terms of needing to help their family members, very concerned about their welfare.
The Tasmanian government's giving the service $50,000 of emergency funding, and other migrant support organisations will share in about $35,000.
That's basically going to allow us to hire another 2 to 3 more legal staff to basically lodge as many visa applications as we can as soon as we possibly can.
The Tasmanian government's also accepting another repatriation flight of Australians returning from the United Kingdom, freeing up space in hotel quarantine in other states for Afghan refugees. The flight will arrive this Sunday. 150 returning travellers will quarantine at the Hotel Ibis in central Hobart. The government says the UK's high vaccination rate reduces the chance of COVID cases, but it's taking measures to minimise the risk.
Everyone is tested, has to have a negative test prior to, of course, the flight, during quarantine, and will not be released from quarantine, of course, until proven negative.
The Greens want the government to lobby for a high proportion of Afghan refugees to be resettled in Tasmania.
Pick up the phone and call Scott Morrison and let him know that Tasmanians want to play our part in homing those fleeing people.
Of course, we're open-minded to that support, and of course we'll be working with the Commonwealth to ensure that we again open our hearts and indeed our homeland.
The government's also not ruling out accepting more repatriation flights in the future. Laura Beavis, ABC News.